shout hallelujah. Shout a winning hallelujah. Shout a victorious hallelujah. Come to your neighbor and tell your neighbor, next week you will see me standing here testifying. Hallelujah. Amen. You know, testimony have taken over the program. And, you know, I think we just have to try and allow people to testify about the goodness of God in this house. And I want to reassure you that next week, before this time, you will stand here to testify in the name of Jesus Christ. And you will not only stand here to testify, you will testify in the synagogue church of all nations. Remember, when Jesus Christ signed signature, no one can oppose him. Hallelujah. You know, for me to stand here and hear this testimony of this man. Come here. He said, this man, please look at him. This man, did you hear his testimony?
Yes.
I want to tell you something I never tell him. Demon want to package this man, containerize him, want to send him to Nigeria, never to touch South Africa again. That was the plan. That was the plan. They have already planned, containerize him, just waiting to take him to Old Tambo and say, but the God of this commission, the God of Senior Prophet TB Joshua, canceled that plan. And as his own plan was canceled, every plan to send you on exile or to exile is canceled. In the name of Jesus Christ. You heard his testimony. He didn't tell you everything. He bought a ticket. He came here. Hey, prophet, I have a ticket. I want to go tomorrow. Where is your passport with immigration? How do you want to travel? Where is your ID with immigration? Where is your resident permit with immigration? How do you want to travel? I want to travel by TC or with TC. I have money. Let me travel. Can you imagine that? You've lived here. How many years have you lived here?
It's 15 years now.
There you are. And demon want him to lose everything. 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 They want to. They have already containerized him. But fortunately, the God he worshiped, and that God that brought the daughter alive, amen, was the God that saved him. Amen. And God of Senior Prophet TB Joshua.
Amen.
And God of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob.
Amen.
And the God of Issachar.
Amen.
That is the God that keep this man here today. And you hear his testimony. Look at him, he dressed like an angel from a different world.
Amen.
Listen, from today, every demon that wants to deport you, that demon has been deported.
Amen.
You know how many times he troubled me? He came, he said he went to the immigration. It's okay, he will give him his passport and retrieve the ID. Then he went to immigration. It's okay, give me your ID. No, he told him, the man said, go and buy ticket. He went and bought ticket. He said, come and show me the ticket. Then I will give you passport. Then he brought the ticket. Did you bring the ticket?
Yes, I brought the ticket and then I went to show.
Hang on. He brought the ticket and he showed him. Then he released his passport and took the ID. I said, okay, when you're about to confirm everything, I will give it to you the day you are going to the airport. Don't worry. Can you imagine how tricky this demon is? Then we place him on fasting. When he completed the fasting, he came back. Yes, I want to travel tomorrow. I said, this man, demon is very trickish. I'm telling you, very, very trickish. Very trickish. But today, my heart is full of joy. Yeah. And I am singing a new song because I saw all those documents brought back to him. Yeah. Congratulations. All the years you stayed in this country, let me tell you, your passport has been given to you.
Amen.
Go. It is done. Is done. Listen, the same immigration that took your passport, your permanent resident, will call you and give you your citizenship.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
No power can change
it. Thank you, Jesus.
The money is very trickish. He wanted the 15 years he spent in this country to go. Huh? He wanted this 15 years to disappear. Okay, look at the one that was blind. There was another story behind that blindness, which we will tell you later. Amen. Hallelujah.
Amen.
And the other sister of fibroid, imagine the big growth in her. She brought it. I was shocked that day. I said, do you mean to tell me that this thing is inside your body? She said, yes. And I'm going again for another operation. I said, no, not in this house.
Amen.
I saw you sit in this front seat here. Never. Say, thank you, Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus.
That is why demon always makes sure that he doesn't want you to remain here. He will tell you, look at your time. Hey, that church, they don't close on time. You are hungry, go and eat. At least go and eat. From eating, Valanda Paul. Hallelujah. Very trickish. But all his enterprise, his trick, his business, has been defeated.
Amen.
It has been defeated in your life.
Amen.
Has been defeated in your life. Look at numerous testimonies. All because of Christ.
Amen.
Not because of anyone else, but because he loves you before you love him.
Amen.
Because he chose you. Hallelujah.
Amen.
You might look at your situation. Look at that sister, 4 years, no money from where she was working. She's been coming here. She went to Synagogue Church of Foundation, and when she came back, she said, she was expecting the money to be released. But one thing she does not know, if that money was released that time, the demon will put hand and take it. Our God is more clever than demon.
Amen.
Your God is more clever than Satan.
Amen.
And his agent.
Amen.
He went, whew, and locked it there, said, relax. Let me perfect that which I began.
Amen.
Then I'll release your money.
Amen.
Your own situation, he knows it.
Amen.
He knows those troubles you're going through. He knows that night, all the nights you never sleep. He knows it. He's aware.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
He is aware. Amen. But another thing which he's trying to do is to make sure you are not here. Is to make sure you don't stand here. Okay, look at what is going on in Senegal Church of Foundation. Oh, the church was brought down. This was brought down. This happened. Structural failure. This failure because of the good work. Whenever you come out to do the work of Christ, in truth and in spirit, there will be challenges. There will be challenges. But please, when you are facing challenges and others are coming to tell you there's a solution there, come to this church. Church cannot save you.
Amen.
What will save you is standing by the word and in the word of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. When the word prevails. So stand by the word. Stand on the word. Because his word is a rock. He said, upon this rock I will build my church, and the gate of hell shall not prevail. He said, the gate of hell shall not prevail. But the problem today, men look at time and check time for God. That brother that was blind, did he check time for God again? He said, even when the car had an accident, he told the driver, listen, don't talk about your car. Take me to Paraguana Hospital. Take me to Barra. Forget about the car. He said to the wife, no more, I can't see. But instantly he see. And people still here are doubting. Can this be real? But I tell you the truth. Whether you doubt it, whether you believe it, you are the next to testify. Because I have tried and tried to make you stay here, make you stand, make you to be patient. I have my church. Where is your church? Where is your church? I think we need to emphasize on this issue of my church, my prophet, my this, my that. God said, I will give you a pastor after your heart. I will give you a prophet after your heart. Amen. He said, when you stand by my word, I will order your steps. Amen. I will order your steps. A pastor cannot save you. The only thing that can save you is the word of the Father. Amen. Having confidence in the word of the Father. Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. They said, is this one? Is Synagogue Church of Foundation? Is a structure of this? What? I know how many of you have been to synagogue. What you see? Have you ever seen such a building? Let's forget about Egypt and some other old ancient country. In Africa, in the present age, have you ever seen such a structure? I've never seen myself. I've never seen. There's no one that enters synagogue and say, how did this man come about this decoration? This is divine. A boy went and testified. A scientist. He came out with this. He said, International Journal of Scientists, Engineering, and Research, IJSER. You will read it. It's on the internet also. This is the founding of the structure, chemical and whatever that is used. Listen, our battle is not a carnal one. It's a spiritual warfare. Amen. Don't blame the people that are fighting Synagogue Church of Foundation, but pray for your prophet and pray for yourself. Pray for the church of Christ. Pray for the body of Christ, because there are crises in the body of Christ. So demon knows that as soon as the body of Christ is united, they will do nothing. So he's busy multiplying his prophets, his pastors, his apostles. And this name, pastors, prophet, have destroyed a lot of things. I praise God that in this church we are not going to have pastors again. Amen. We are going to have disciples, if there is any. Disciples. We're going to have evangelists. Because the moment you call somebody a pastor, he carries shoulder up. What is there? What can you do? You are serving a master that you can't see face to face if he does not give you the grace. And then you are carrying your shoulder up because of the material things. Where is the material things going to take you to? God said, when you serve me, I will clothe you. When you serve me faithfully, in spirit and in truth. He said, I am sending you. Take not bag. Take not a spare shoe. Think not what to eat. Say, go, I will make them available. I am standing here. This shoe I wear, this shoe on my feet was given to me. This suit, this jacket and the trouser was given by a sister. This very shirt was given by a brother. Tell me, which one is mine? The sister maybe is here. And maybe the brother is here. Believe me. Yeah, the one that gave me this shirt is here. Also, the one that gave me the jacket is here. It's the one that gave me the shoe. If that one come here, in fact, if I see him here, I'll say, okay, this is your shoe. Take. Now, I remove also the jacket. The one that gave me the jacket and trouser, I remove. I said, take your own. Which one belongs to me? Nothing. Just by the word. I am standing here in the name of Jesus Christ and telling you this truth. Was given to me. The wristwatch in my hand was also given to me. The brother is here. But if I ask them to come out and take their things now, you say, what is wrong with our pastor? He said, think not. But today, because of material things, I want to drive aircraft because that pastor has an aircraft. Do you know how the person come about private jet? So why don't you give glory to the Father for what he has given to you? Glorify him. Be content with what he has made available to you. Even in sickness and trial, be contented. Be contented. Because the trials will be there. Our Lord Jesus Christ was tried. We just finished 3 days and 3 nights. And that was the 3 days and 3 nights. Our Lord Jesus Christ stayed in the belly of the earth. 72 hours he stayed there. Did he drink? Did he bath? Did he brush his teeth? And maybe you are the one that was, serving him that time. You went through it. Jonah went to that journey. And you come out. Who do you think can defeat you? No one. I guarantee you, no one. No one. They will try you. They will frame things against you. They will conspire against you. But fear not, for Christ is with you. Christ is with you. So this is the scientific analogy by a brother that was doing research. He came out with exactly what happened. Pray for the world we are in. Pray for the body of Christ. Pray for the body of Christ. Look at it. Just pick, take it by the camera. Can you focus? Can you see? What do you see? Can you see it? Can you see? These are the chemical things we are watching. We are in the world of dangerous. We're in a dangerous world. Huh? Look at here. Elimination of the structural failure and the placement of chemical explosions, option for the infrasonic weapon option as the cause of the Synagogue Church of All Nations building collapse. It's in the internet. You read. Look at it. It's in the internet. So where are we? Let us pray for the body of Christ. If God says someone will die, you will surely die through that way he has ordained for you. Many people on the road. Okay, look at the sister that testified. How many people had accidents in one day? 3. The other one was going with a car. He was stagnated to die. But the father sustained him. The other one, the wife was going to the hospital to see the husband. She was attacked. The brother also jumped into the car, was attacked. Hallelujah. Now ask the sister, how much did the government pay him? Every time our mind is on money, 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 money. Hello. When you are born in this world, how much did you brought in? No, 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 you are lying. Ah, no, stop lying. You did not lie? Are you sure? You come with how much? Even 50 cents? 10 cents? 1 cent? Okay, let's rule it off that you did not come with money. How many shoes you come with? How many bag you come with? How many trousers? How many the other one? Naked you come and naked you go back. This issue of give me insurance when I die, I will leave. The people you are leaving the money with, are you, how are you sure they're going to enjoy it? Medical insurance, this insurance, that insurance. Every day my phone is ringing. Hey, I want to give you insurance. I said, which insurance you want to give me? They will promise you 1 million, 10 million, 100 million. Come and take. Eh? I'm not saying to take insurance is not good. But I'm saying, remove your mind from the material things. Remove your mind from the material things. Think about the things of heaven. Erase material things from your heart. If you come to serve God in spirit and in truth. Do not envy another person that is doing well. Do not envy another person that is the president. Please remove your mind from persecuting others. Think about the things of heaven as a child of God. Leave the one that is progressing to progress. Your time will come and you will progress. Your time will come and you will progress. Your time will come. Everything on this earth has their own time. If you are to be a medical doctor and to be recognized later as a professor in medicine, the Lord will take you there. Amen. Forget about the people that are there before. There was a sister that testified here. She couldn't pay $400, or she later paid $400. If you had the testimony of the parents, you'd be shocked. 2000, where's that sister? She has gone back to her office. Where is she? Mimi, were you here in the church when the father was brought to the church? The father was paralyzed. You know, paralyzed? Completely. At the bed, about to die. The mother came all the way from Zimbabwe. All the way from Zimbabwe. And when I called the newcomers, before the newcomers, she ran to me. Hey, prophet, my husband is dying. You must heal my husband. I said, what offense have I committed? You must heal my husband. Now I look at the person that was talking to me. I realize he's the one that kept the man in the hospital. I discovered it was not the woman that was talking, but the one that kept that man in the hospital, the one that paralyzed the man. I said, Jesus, what is going on? Sorry for keeping you standing. I said, Jesus, what is going on? I said, okay, the church, watch. This woman said they want the husband to be healed out of the hospital. I said, okay, the man is healed. He said, no, he must die. He must die. Why must you say he must be healed? He must die today. I polarize him. I finish him. Now the church says, But this was the person that came, that the husband is in the hospital and about to die. So I said, okay, let the man live. He said, no, the man will not live. He has to die. Now, can you see who is fighting you? Eventually, when she was delivered, she said, I asked, what did you say? He said, no, my husband in the hospital. I said, but he's healed. He said, oh, thank you, Jesus. This was not the real woman talking. So the battle we are fighting is not flesh and blood. It's a spiritual warfare. That is why don't blame anybody for anything. Rather, pray for the person. Pray for the person. Stand on the word of God. This is what we are going through. Please, pray for the church of God. Pray for the church of God. Pray for the church of God. Pray for your men of God, Senior Prophet T.B. Joshua. Pray for all the pastors, bishops, deacons, deaconesses, and pray for yourself. It's a warfare. This is the end time. This is the
end time.
End time. This is the end time. Please pray for the church of God. Please. There's attack everywhere. There's a frames of numerous, campaigns of colonies. So let us pray for the church. So now I want us to pray for the church all over the world. Let us pray for the church. Let us pray for the church of God. Let us pray for the pastors. Let's pray for the prophets. Let's pray for bishops. Let's pray for Pope. Let's pray for all. Open your lips, begin to pray. Ask God to have mercy on the universe. Ask God to have mercy. Ask God to have mercy. Ask God to have mercy to our nations, our brothers and sisters out there. Let him have mercy. Let his mercy speak for us. Let his favor speak for us. Ask him to have mercy. Ask him to have mercy on the world. Ask him to have mercy. Ask him to have mercy on our brothers and sisters. Ask him to have mercy. Ask him to have mercy. Ask him to forgive. Ask God to have mercy. Ask for the mercy of God. In Jesus Christ's name we pray. Amen. It is done. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. It is done. It is done. The mercy of God will prevail. Amen. In the name of our Lord Jesus Christ. Amen. So it is well with you. Amen. May you be wonderfully seated. May you be wonderfully seated. Please, beginning from now, pray for this nation, South Africa. Pray for the nation, Nigeria. Pray for nations all over the world. Don't pray for yourself. Pray for nations this week. Pray for nations. Pray for churches. Pray for Pope. Pray for all the saints. Pray for them. Because the battle is a real battle. It's a real battle. Pray for me. Anyone that stands to say the word of God, pray for him. Because the battle right now is between darkness and light. Hallelujah. It's between darkness and light. It's between darkness and light. For the little years we've been in this ministry, I have sat down and cried and asked God, what is really happening? What is really happening? People will be here, they see someone being delivered, they say, they will still do bad in the house of God. Some people will come and say, give me money. What business are you doing? Come and have business with you. In the same house, thinking the prophet does not know. Some will take number, try to do some rubbish business with you, eating your money, doing a lot of things. Please, do not give anybody your number in this house, eh? Every number, and if anyone tell you any business, please go on your knees and pray and fast for the person that God should forgive him. Because if God wants to connect you to someone, he will reveal that to you. He will reveal it to you. There are so many people that are not scared. In fact, demon knows that the only place to operate is in the house of God. And that was what he's busy doing. See, Facebook, they will go and take my picture and put and say, Pastor Isaka, Prophet Isaka, Bishop Isaka, Deacon Isaka, Elder Isaka, they are the one. They will carry TB Joshua. Hello, I'm Prophet TB Joshua. Money. Where are they? Can they reason? You realize when the person is delivered, hey, no, I never do such a thing. I don't know what come over me. Who is responsible? Demon is responsible. Demon is responsible. And the moment you come in the church, you want to sit down, it's a trouble. They will tell you, no, don't be in that church. Hey, that church, they don't close on time. Look at that church. Imagine, you come by 8 o'clock, you go by 10 o'clock. Is that a church? And now, if you are left, well, if that man, for instance, that brother that was blind, and the doctor said to him, you have to be in this hospital for 1 month on the same bed 1 month, then after you see. Would he do it or not? Where's that brother? Where is he? Where is he? Brother, come. Come. Let's learn something today. Brother, how are you? Congratulations.
Fine.
You're no more blind?
No more, no more. I can see you.
Now you can see. You can see me.
I can see you.
You know that day when I come closer to him, he said, I'm blind. I can't read. I'm blind. And today he confessed that a brother told him to shout, I'm blind. Blind Bartimaeus cried before Jesus Christ located him. So if you come here, you want to keep quiet. Myself, I can even keep quiet and go to another person that needs me. The same thing God does. That is why he said to you, knock, and it shall be opened unto you. Seek, and you shall find. Ask, and you shall receive. But some come here and keep quiet. When they say, pray, say, this people seems they are not normal. Look at the way they are screaming. In my church, we just do, you know, thank you, Lord. And we go home. I'm okay. How can I go to that church to scream? Brother, that time you were going through, you say you are holding your two head.
Yes.
How were you holding the hands? You are holding your hands that way.
Yeah, my head. I was holding
the hands. So if doctor have told, ask you, said to you, okay, you stay in this hospital for 1 month, then this head will come down and you will see again. What would you do?
That time I could stay in the hospital.
You will stay?
Yes.
Thank you. Now, if I ask you to stay 3 days here, what would you do?
To stay 3 days here for healing.
If I ask you if I ask you now, you're going to stay 3 days here. What will you say to me?
Now I can stay.
Okay, now you can stay. But before then, if I ask anybody now, you say, hey, my wife, my children, my car, my house rent. Anyway, congratulations. I will complete my word.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you. When they come, sit down, let Christ heal you. No, my husband, my wife, money, sure, my house rent. This is it. That's what you think about. But when trouble comes now, hey, doctor, in fact, if you can cut this leg and leave me with one, give me crutches, this pain is getting... Doctor, come and cut it. This is it. And you come to church. Now, go. The leg is healed. That is all? How do you think demon that put that thing there will be happy? How do you think demon that put that thing on there will be happy? You know, immediately this brother was healed, something happened somewhere. Something great happened somewhere. Something great happened somewhere. But I will not say it now. You will hear it later. Because the angels are busy trying to perfect that side also. Something very great that will shock you. We were conducting deliverance in Moy Street. A sister came with a husband. Out. Say, no, I took the money. They brought money to me. I'm grandmother. I took the money. I buried it in the yard. They have to be poor. That's okay. Now, if they have to be poor, let Christ bury you. The sister was delivered. The same minute, the daughter in Zimbabwe went blind. Same minute, the daughter in Zimbabwe went blind. We finished church. As soon as she's still in the church, telephone ring. Hey, your daughter cannot read. She cannot see again. In fact, they are leading her. She's blind. They have to call me back. Daddy, I was delivered here. My daughter went blind. What is this? What is happening? I said, okay, demon now want to try your daughter. Come. The eyes now was open. As the eyes was open, something else, I will not tell you what happened after that.
their money was returned. But you come here, you see all these things happening. You remember your church in Maputo. And another one in Bulawayo. Another one in Valandapo. You can search where it's located in the dictionary and in the map of Africa. You want to go there. Church cannot save you. Church cannot save you. The only thing that can save you is the word of God. Standing in the word of God, standing by the truth, forgiving, forgiveness, forgive others, and share what you have with others. Share what you have with others and remain seated in the house of God. I always say to you, when God say, sit down, you must sit down. But this day they refuse to sit down. They are checking time for Christ. Huh? Like now I know. How many times you've checked time? When is he coming out? Not knowing that God's time is the best. Hallelujah. God's time is the best. Look at the sister came all the way from Cape Town. It was through the Facebook. She went through. How many of you have been logging into liking the Shekinah Glorious Faith Ministry Facebook? You don't know it? Some of you don't know it? You don't know the Facebook? Huh? It's Shekinah Glorious Faith Ministry. Yes. You don't like it? But whether you like it, you click like. You don't click like. Christ will do his work. In the name of Jesus Christ. You know what? Why I'm always telling you whether you like it or not? Because the Father has perfected that which has begun in our life. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. So you have come here with numerous sickness. Your sickness is over. Amen. You have come in here with diverse problems. Those problems are over. Amen. In the name of Jesus Christ. Amen. Do you know why some people are representing their daughters and sons testifying here? I gave them one testimony about Rasta. Rasta came to church and I was laying hands. I came to Rasta. Rasta came all the way from Soweto. I said, hey, young man, I see you doing something. And this thing you love is so much. He said, eh? I said, you love this thing so much. You are coming here for the first time. Do you know me? He said, no. I said, okay, where is Chike? Chike was here then, and so many people were here. I said, Rasta, there's something you love most. Can you do it for my God? He said, tell me, I will do it. Sure, I will do it. I said, there's something you love most. He said, tell me, what is that? And he was thinking I'm going to tell him about chicken, about meat, about eating, about women, about what. I told him, that thing you like is do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. He said, what is that? I said, bass guitar. You play it very well. He screamed. He said, how do you know me? I play bass guitar very well. I love it more than anything. I said, can you play for God? He said, yes. I said, if you can play it, because now you are jobless. If you can play for God, you will get a job now. He said, I will. He went to the choir, the musical instrument said he played. I said, okay. Then Rasta went home, no job. Our God was busy doing something. Eventually, next week, Rasta came back to church. Then we start laying hands again. Then we come to Rasta. I said, Rasta, would you want to work in a bakery now as a manager? He said, yes, the job is there. He said, how? I said, job is there, bakery. I smell the bread. I smell good things there. And that good thing is going to take you far if you can serve my God. I'm telling you how this God work. Eventually, we finished church. Telephone did not ring. He jumped into the same cab. On the way to Bramfisher, as soon as he dropped down from the car, somebody said, hey, Rasta, how are you? Woza, come. Rasta came and said, Rasta, there is a job now in my company. They want a foreman, somebody that will manage the bakery. Would you want to do it? He said, ah. His senses come back. He said, the prophet told him about bakery, and now his friend is telling him about bakery. He said, yes, yes, yes. Rasta got a job. Same minute. You're clapping hand. You're clapping hand. Wait, let me land before you clap your hand. Now, eventually, Rasta sent a message, he's got a job. Next Sunday, Rasta never come to church. No testimony, no tithe, no dun 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 dun. That finished. Rasta continued to make money, eat nice food, go to club, play his dun 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 dun. First month, 2 months, 3 months, Rasta was enjoying. One day, there was no person playing bass guitar. I saw the people, where is the Rasta? No, Rasta is busy. Eventually, I saw Rasta hanged, dead. I said, come, go and tell Rasta, I saw death now for refusal to serve God. I saw death. They went and told Rasta. Rasta said, hey, forget about pastor. Pastor wants my money. And when Rasta came to the church, I paid transport from Ramfisher for them to come and worship. If I put 10 vehicles, the 10 vehicles fill up. We opened a branch in Ramfisher 4 months after opening Shekinah with over 400 members. Just to tell you where you are, this part of my history and the history of this church. Eventually, first week, 2 weeks, 1 month passed, Rasta came back home, brought money, kept the money. The girlfriend took the money, went and managed it for him. Rasta came back and got angry, put a rope and hung himself. He died. Because he lost the job, Rasta was fired, and when he came back to the house, the money disappeared. So Rasta have no more hope. He forgot that the God that gave him the money and the job will give him again. If only he can come back to him and say, Father, I am sorry. This is the mistake of a man. This is a mistake. Rasta hung himself. A couple of times I told him, Rasta is dead. Please tell Rasta I want to see Rasta. He never came. He passed on. So you today, harden not your heart. When God do something for you, come at least testify and tell him, like the sister said, the son is too busy, isn't it? He got back the job. He was fired. On the way coming for prayer, he got back the job, isn't it? Now, she remembered that testimony I gave. I cannot even remember. If not today, I didn't remember I gave the testimony of Rasta here. She ran to come and say, no, I don't want my son to die like Rasta. This place you are, God is a dangerous God. He is. He said, I never share my glory with no man. If he bless you with something and you appreciate him for that thing, he will bless you the more. But why people are suffering today is because there is no word of God growing in their heart. And as of Apostles chapter 19, verse 20 said, and the word of God prevail. And the word of God prevail. You can never prevail against the word of God. The word of God will always prevail against every mundane things of this world. And over your thinking faculties, the word of God will prevail. Stand on the word of God. Stand on the word of God. So my message today is just simple. Stand on the word of God. Stand on the word of God. Because the word of God is a rock. The word of God is a rock. Stand on his word. And the word prevail. And the word prevail. Stand on the word. When God have done something for you, no matter what God have done for you, come and testify for that thing to be permanent. God bless you with a bicycle, come out and say, others are driving an aircraft. Yes, Oh, thank you, Jesus. Brethren, God bless me with a bicycle. And then God will say, eh? I give this man bicycle. Okay. I'll bless him with BMW. And he will give you BMW. If you come to give him thanks for the BMW, he will give you an aircraft. That is God. He said, I derive joy in the testimony of my children. I am here today because of testimony. My father in the law, son of Prophet T.B. Joshua, is there today because of testimony. And Satan is angry because of that. So for Satan to be more angry and you go forward, stand and testify the goodness of the Lord in your life. Hallelujah. And don't be always hurry, I want to go home. What are you going to get at home? The best place to be is in the house of God, in the presence of God. It's in the presence of God. Where else would you be? The one that created you, no respect. Some even said, I'm God myself. God has failed me. How can God fail you? The one that created you fail you. It has never happened. God fail no man. It's we that fail God because we forgot the covenant we have with him. When he created heaven and earth, he stated in Genesis, he gave man authority to take dominion, authority to make use of everything, handle, manage everything he has created. He gave it to you. He gave it to you. Even when you are jobless, come and testify and tell us you are jobless, and God will give you a job. I'm telling you. Oh, I found myself here, you know. I was jobless, and I know I have had the testimony of others, and I know my own is here. You might testify, finish, I tell you all is well. Your mind that time, he heard it here. This man doesn't know what I'm going through. He's telling me all is well, and what nothing is well. But whether something is well or is not well, all I know, because what I could see, is it is well. It is well. It is well. That sister that testified 12 years, no pregnancy. The husband came to look for a job. Just to get a job to pay transport. He asked me. I know how to play talking drum. I said, what is talking drum? Say that thing. I said, okay, you know how to play it. He said, yes, but I don't have transport to come to church. So when I play, you give me transport to come to church. I said, okay. Then the wife, they were sitting there. I said, okay, but your wife need baby. And I saw a baby boy there. The woman said, this man, they say he's a prophet. For 12 years, he's just say, there's a baby boy. Just like that. Listen, when God wants to diagnose what is in your system, he does not need any equipment because he got them already. Amen. The doctor will say the womb is closed, but there's a spare womb in the warehouse of my father. Amen. All he has to do, take the womb and replace it, and the baby will come. Shout hallelujah. And the baby will come. That boy, the brother that was here that testified, you know what God did? He just took another eyes from the warehouse and replaced that one. And that was all. Then he began to see. How can you imagine someone has gone to hospital, there was no other hope? Taking 24, how many medicine? 72. Every second is eating the thing. Hallelujah. And here he comes. No more. How do you think your case is too hard for God to handle? Eh? Whatever name doctor call it is nothing for my God. Even your pocket tell you, hey, your landlord is going to fire you today. They're going to close the door. Trouble not yourself. Because my father is on the throne. And because he remained on the throne, that landlord can never. Even he claimed to be the owner of the house, that house can be handed over to you. I'm telling you. Hallelujah.
The sister said, the landlord, come, why can't you say something, at least pay something? She also wants to show herself. A woman of God. She wants to show. He said, no, I'm not paying anything. I don't have money. But that debt is canceled. Amen. Remember, last week I was telling you people about debt cancellation. That's it. So whatever you're going through, trouble not yourself. Trouble not you are. But stand on his word. His word. When that word prevails over your thinking faculties, God steps in. Because in the state of nothingness, he derived joy in bringing something out of nothing. And when he brings that, he doesn't want to share the blessings, the glory with no man. He doesn't want to share it. That's why when you come here, he say, hey, prophet, pray for, am I the one that pray for you? It's your father that heal you and restore you. He only used me as an instrument to facilitate that which has begun or what you want to do. Look at the blind Bartimaeus. Look at the crippled man at the beautiful gate. It's called gate, isn't it? That gate is called what? Beautiful. Was anything beautiful at all in that gate? Nothing beautiful in that gate at all. Nothing to talk. The only thing that is beautiful is that at least they can eat. Hallelujah. Every other thing is rubbish. Peter said to him, silver, gold have I? None. Such I have, I give you. Rise in the name of Jesus Christ. Go home. And he went home. He went home. So when you come in here, don't expect me. You know the anointing water we are giving you is just to fast forward your faith. I'm telling you the truth. Even lay hands on you, it's just for fast forward their faith. Because so many people come here and say, hey, you know, that man never lay hands on me. In fact, if he can touch me, if he can touch me or prophesy to me, if I prophesy to you and the father did not confirm it, where would the prophecy take you to? Okay, I know your name. I know the father knows the name of everybody here. Jeremiah, the brother, read it. Jeremiah chapter 1. Why you're in your mother's womb? He knew you. He knew you before you are formed. So why, how do you think or imagine that God does not know you? He spoke the word. I know you. Jesus said, in the beginning was the word. And the word was with God. And the word was God. And the word became a flesh. Dwelleth among men. The same word enlightened the world, but the world did not comprehend it. Why? Because the world know it not. John 17. He prayed for you in John 17. He prayed for you. That in the beginning was the word was God. St. John's Gospel chapter 1. He said, in the beginning was the word. So from the beginning, the same word in Genesis, the Father used, said, let there be light. And there was light. Now, how do you expect us to always give you something? It's just to fast forward your faith. This oil is fast forward your faith. The water you fetch from your house is to fast forward your faith and to prove that God is real. I can call 10 people that are here, coming for the first time, or even 100 people. Fetch your water. You fetch your water, can I tell you, when the Holy Spirit comes, nobody will stand with the water here. You'll be on the floor. You'll be on the floor because he will put anointing and that anointing will carry you down. He is the one that does it, not man. So don't worship man, worship God. Worship God. Worship God. Worship God. So it is well with you. Amen. It is well with you. This way with you. In Isaiah chapter number 40, verse number 6, reading through 11. Isaiah. Are you there? Beginning from verse number 6, what does it say? Shout hallelujah. He said, the voice said, cry. And he said, what shall I cry? What shall I cry? All flesh is grass, and all the goodliness thereof is as the flowers of the field. All the goodliness thereof are like the flowers of the field. Hallelujah. Which means whatever you are today, you can be finished in 1 second. God can finish you in 1 second. And God can restore you in 1 second. Amen. He does not need permission from you to restore you. Neither does he need the permission from you to do anything. You say, I am God, I give it life, and I take it life. I do whatever pleases me, and you cannot question me because I'm an unquestionable God. But today, man fell because you question God. Hey, why am I suffering? Why is my children not going to school? Why are my children suffering? Why is it that I have no job? Why is it that my money is not paid? Why God? Why God? Why God? Now, if God asks you why, what would you say? Go and read the book of Job. He began to ask Job, when have you commanded the morning? When I formed the earth, where were you? When I do this, where were you? When I did this, where were you? Job said, I'm sorry. Daddy, I'm sorry. I was not there. Have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. But up to today, you don't learn from the mistake of others. You begin to question God. Even this morning before you come here, some of you make decisions. In fact, if I go to that church, that man did not touch me. Mm-mm. I will not go again. He has to talk to me today. Yes, it's a good decision. It's a quality decision. I love that. And I'm talking to you now. Your case is settled. Your case is settled. And that's all. If my father said your case is settled, who can change it? No one. No one. That sister said she was looking for her money. The case is with what? The case has been pending for years, and now it's with the CC. Is it CCMA, or what did she say? Eh? Labor court. Sister, may I ask you, can you tell us now, what do you want concerning that case? What do you want?
I want my money and I want victory.
Because I've got. That is all.
I want my job back. I want to be reinstated. And I want everything that belongs to me and my losses back to me. In Jesus' name.
Come and say it. Let everybody see you. So that they don't say this is magic. It's not magic. It's the word prevail. It's the word prevail. I'm seeing her for the first time. I don't know her. Do you know me? Have you ever seen me?
No. Only on your picture.
Only on the picture? Shout hallelujah. Hallelujah. Okay, tell us what you want. Again?
I want reinstatement and I want everything back that they've taken from me and all my losses.
Okay, that is what you want.
Yes.
When do you want it?
Now.
And it is done now.
Amen. Amen. Thank you.
You know, the two men that were conspiring against you, they are already in trouble. They conspired. All the whole thing, but all was for the glory of the Father.
Amen.
But today, the Father has reinstated you. Do you drive?
Yes.
You drive. Congratulations for the new car. Finish. Finish. That's all. That's all. That is all the Father has for her. And it is done. Stand up, you're free. Stand up. You are free forever. You are free. Come back for a great testimony and a new car key. Because one, your money is paid, a better job, better house.
Amen.
Because for years, demon is sitting on what belongs to you.
Amen.
But it is over.
Thank you, Jesus.
Come back with a testimony. in the name of Jesus Christ. What? The word prevail. The word prevail. You know, some comes and say, no, I want this, this, that. You come for the word of the Father. Come for the word of the Father. Just come for the word. Remember the woman with the issue of blood. Say, if I can only touch. Not the man touching him. I mean, touching her. But she said, if I can only touch the hem of his garment. Not Christ touching her and saying, you are free. Or speaking in tongue. Oh, yes, sir. Not that. If I can only touch. If I can only touch. If I can only touch. My case is settled. Thank you, Jesus. Well, let's read further. We're going to quickly read up to down to verse 11. Then verse 7. The grass withereth, the flower faded, because the Spirit of the Lord bloweth upon it. Surely the people is grass. Surely the people is grass. The grass withereth, the flower faded, but the word of our God shall stand forever. What will stand forever? The word of our God will stand forever. Forever. Oh Lord, Yahweh is settled forever, forever. Oh Lord, Yahweh is settled forever, forever, forever. Oh Lord. Settle your case. So stand on the word of God. That song says, I'm standing on the word of God. The word of God is powerful. I am standing on the word of God.
The word of God is powerful.
I am standing on the word of God. Standing on
standing on the word of God, there is no power that can take you down. No winch, no wizard that can take you down. If you stand on the word of God. But remember, I quote my father in the law, Senator Prophet T.B. Joshua, in the university of God, however brilliant you are, you must take every course. Because each course serves a purpose. Each course serves a purpose. So when you are standing on the word of God, you'll be tested. Your faith will be contested. You'll be examined. But may the Father find you still standing.
Amen.
On that day.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Standing on the word. Standing on the word is what prevail. The Bible said the word of God prevail. Let the word of God prevail over your thinking faculties. The moment the word of God prevails over your situation, the challenges are over.
Amen.
The difficulties are over.
Amen.
Those mountains become surmountable. Those trials diminished. That empty pocket refilled. That deteriorated health restored.
Amen.
I have seen it. His word never fell.
Amen.
His word remained the same. His word remained the same. While you are still standing, I will read this for you. Psalm 119, verse 98. While you are still standing. Concerning the word of God. Concerning the word. Concerning the word. Psalms 119. In verse number 90, said, thou through thy commandment hast made me wiser than my enemies, for they are ever with me. Thy word hath made me wiser than my enemies. The only thing that can make you wiser than the enemies is the word of God.
Amen.
It's the word of God that can make you wiser than the enemies. It's the word of God that you stand upon that prevails over every situation in your life. Abraham was 100, the wife 90, and the angel of God said to him, God speaking through the angels, say, your wife will beget a child, a boy. Your own. He doubted. Now the question is this. It was a physical encounter with God. A physical encounter, not spiritual manifestation, but spiritual encounter with God. They say, but your wife is smiling there, doubting what you're saying. Sarah lied and said, no, I don't doubt. I didn't smile. How can this be possible? He said, I am old. I am a finished woman. I'm a finished woman. God never finished with you.
Amen.
He only begins with you.
Amen.
Where the faith of man ends is where God begins. When man's power ends is where Christ comes in. When your power finishes. So why don't you always go on your knees and say, Father, I have no power of my own. Just like that song said, I have no power of my own. I have no power of my own. I confess to you, Holy Spirit of the Lord.
I have no
power of my own.
I have no
power.
chapter 1, verse number 13. Hold fast the form of sound words, which thou hast heard of me in faith and love, which is in Christ Jesus. What are you going to hold firm on?
The word you heard from me, the word I spoke to you. Hold firm unto it. Because this word I speak is not my word, but the word of the Father. And his word never fell.
Amen.
He never fell. Say, hold fast the firm of sound words, which thou heard of me, in faith and love, which is in Christ Jesus. In faith and love, which is in Christ Jesus. Not which is in the church. Which is in Christ Jesus. Hold firm unto it. The sound word. The sound word. He went further to say, the good thing which was committed unto thee, keep by the Holy Ghost, which dwelleth in us. Verse number 15. This thou knowest, that all they which are in Asia he turns away from me, of whom Ephialos and Hermanios, the Lord give mercy unto the house of Ephorios. The Lord give mercy. It's only the Lord that showed mercy. So we are here by his mercy. We are not here because we come here on our own. But I want to tell you, because you have no power of your own, the mercy of God, the word of God, which we are standing on, has given you victory.
Amen.
Over death. Victory.
Amen.
Over poverty.
Amen.
Victory over sickness.
Amen.
Victory over shame.
Amen.
Victory over reproach.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Father.
Thank you, Lord.
We give you praise.
Amen.
For you have answered.
Thank you.
In Jesus Christ's name we pray.
Amen.
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 Heavenly Father, we thank you.
Thank you, Lord.
Lord, you have given us the word, and your word is sufficient unto us.
Amen.
Father, you said that the stroke of a cane is sufficient unto the wise.
Yes,
that let those who have ear to hear, let them hear.
Amen.
Father, may your word prevail over every situation in our life today.
Amen.
May your word prevail over our circumstances,
Amen.
Over our situation, over our trials,
Amen.
Over our knowledge,
Amen.
Over our wisdom,
Amen.
May your word prevail,
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Thank you, Heavenly Father.
Thank you, Lord.
We give you praise. For in Jesus Christ's name we pray.
Amen,
amen and amen.
Amen.
Shout hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Put your hands together for the Lord Jesus Christ. Showers of blessings.
Amen.
Showers of abundance.
Amen.
Success.
Amen.
Increase.
Amen.
Multiplication has been released to you. In Jesus Christ's name, it is done. Put your hands together for the Lord Jesus.